Good afternoon, students and my friends. Today we are going to start with the derivative, finding the derivative, numerical differentiation with the help of numerical methods. So numerical differentiation can be found out with three different methods. First is methods based on interpolation. Second one is the methods based on finite difference operators. And lastly, methods based on the undetermined coefficients. Okay, so as per our syllabus, I'm going to focus on methods based on interpolation. So in my last sessions, we have studied the interpolation. We have seen with equal step size, unequal step size, Newton's forward, Newton's backward. So today we are going to solve numericals based on the numerical differentiation with Newton's forward and Newton's difference table. So there is a derivation for finding out the interpolation. So it is very simple. You can, I'll provide you these notes, okay? Or you can take down the screenshots. It is very simple. I mean, steps are very simple. Only we are putting xr is equal to x0 plus rh, and we are finding out the derivative as per your regular method. And we are making use of the Newton's forward difference interpolation formula. So I will take a detailed derivation if time permits, but today we are going to discuss about how to solve the numerical derivative with the help of interpolation method, okay, forward and backward difference interpolation. So let us start with a numerical. Okay, we have given a table, so this is the table for x and y. Different values are given, and we are interested to find out dy by dx and d square y by dx square. So single derivative and double derivative at the data point x equal to 1.2. So you can see here data points are from 1, 1.2, 1.4, 1.6. So all are equal step size. So we are interested to find out the derivative at this corresponding point of interpolation. Okay. So let us see how to solve. So as per our regular method, we'll form the difference table. So this is the x column, this is the y column, this is partial table. Okay, remaining table is there in my next slide here. So you can make a complete table. Okay, you have to write first column is x, given values you have to write. Next column is y, you have to write the y values. Then as our regular Newton forward difference table, interpolation table, we'll find out delta y. Okay, it is called as delta y or del y. If we are following Newton's backward difference, we are calling it as del y. If it is forward difference, we are calling it as delta y. So whenever we are finding out the derivative near to the starting point, okay, we'll apply forward difference. When we are interested to find out, say, at 2 or 2.2, that time we'll go for Newton's backward table and we'll call it as a del y. Okay, but the formation of the table is same. It is, let us say, this is y0, y1, y2. See my cursor, this is y0, y1, y2. Then y1 minus y0 is del y0 or delta y0. Okay, then say 4.0552 minus 3.3201 is 0.7351. So this way you will make the third column. For fourth column, again you have to take the difference, 0.7351, which is delta y1 minus delta y0, 0.6018, will give you delta square y0, which is 0.1333. Okay, in the same way you have to take the difference. Okay, and you have to find out delta square y, delta cube y, delta raised to 4y, delta raised to 5y, delta raised to 6y. So see, I've completed my table here. I'll show you. Yeah, so this is the remaining table which is continued from my last page. Okay, so we will get the readings up to delta raised to, this is x, y, delta 0, delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. This is y, x, y, delta square, delta cube, delta raised to 4, delta raised to 5. This is delta raised to 6, y, 0. Okay, so once you form the table, I don't think there is any difficulty in forming a table. Okay, now we are interested to find out the derivative, single and double derivative, when x0 is 1.2. So at 1.2, y is, see here, 1.2, y is 3.32, 0.01. So at x0 equal to 1.2, y0 is 3.3201. This is given data. H is a step size which we have found out here, which is a equal step size of 0.2. 2.2 minus 2 or 2 minus 1.8 or 1.8 minus 1.6, like that. So everywhere the step size is 0.2, so it is 0.2. Okay. Now we'll apply the formula. Formula is very simple. Single derivative dy upon dx at x equal to x0 is equal to 1 upon h, c1 upon h step size, delta y0 minus 1 by 2 delta square y0 plus 1 by 3 delta cube y0. So see, here it is sign, check the sign of formula, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, like that. Okay, it is 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6, and so on. Okay, I guess you have understood the formula, which is very simple. Now, let us check the values. Now, if you observe, we are interested in delta y0, delta square y0, delta cube y0. So, all y0 terms we are interested in. So, going to the last page, I'll show you. This is x, this is y. Okay. We are interested to find out at 1.2. So this is x0. 1.2 is x0. 3.32 is y0. So this is delta y0. This is delta square y0. And so on. We will go on tracing for y0 terms. So I have given arrow here. All these are my 0 terms. Okay. So it is up to delta raised to 5. This is 5, 4, 3. This column 2, this column 1. Okay. So we have traced this and we have to use these values only. Okay. You can see in the formula, we are using C 0.0014 corresponding to 1.2. Then 0080, C0080. Then 0361, 361. Okay. 0.1627 and 0.73. 1.627, 0.73, because these all corresponds to the required point. We are interested to find out the derivative when x is 1.2. So we'll trace all these diagonal elements, okay, going downward. So all these values are with us. Now it is direct substitution. H is 0.2, rest all values you are knowing with. You can directly put the values and get the derivative. So it is 3.3205. Okay. This is a single derivative. Let us have the formula of double derivative. It is 1 upon h square. See, 1 upon h square. Delta square y0 minus delta cube y0 plus 11 by 12 delta raised to 4 y0. So if you find out the derivative, then you will get this kind of equation. Minus 5 by 6 delta raised to 5 y0 and so on. Okay, here also if you see the signs, plus minus and so on. Okay, and these terms are due to the double derivative. Now here again you are familiar with, now see what value of delta square y0 you have to take. Okay, so delta square y0 is 0.1627, 0.1627. Delta cube y0 is 0.36. Same values you are taking, only coefficients are changing. So with these different coefficients, we have to just substitute the values and get the answer. This is double derivative, which is 3.318. Okay. I hope you have understood and enjoyed my video. So this is how we solve with Newton's forward difference. We can find out the single derivative and the double derivative. Okay. One more problem I'm taking here for calculating the second derivative of the function. So I hope you have understood this. You can find out the single derivative and double derivative also. And the scan is not proper. Otherwise, this was one more numerical for your understanding. Okay, so we'll stop here today. Thank you. If you have not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe it and watch my videos. Thank you for today.